Good morning and welcome to Daily Devo, the best way to start your day in the Word of God. My name is Whitney Mead and welcome to the show. You can find me right here every Monday through Friday morning where we are going to get encouraged, get filled up, and grow closer to the Lord. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell button to get notified every time a new episode of Daily Devo goes live. Are you looking for your next women's retreat speaker? I'd love to help. If you're interested in booking me to speak at your next women's event, reach out to me on my website at whitneymead.com. Now, let's get down to business. "You," said the doctor to his patient, "are in terrible shape. Your health is failing, and unless something is done quickly, you're going to die. You're under too much stress, and you're not eating right. Tell your wife that she has to start cooking healthier meals. And to help reduce your stress levels, have her keep the kids out of your hair so that you can relax when you come home from work. Then make a strict family budget and tell her she has to stick to it. If she does all of these things, you should recover completely. Otherwise, you'll be dead in a month." Shocked, the patient said, "Doctor, would you mind calling my wife before I leave and giving her those instructions?" "Sure," said the doctor. Well, when the man got home, his wife rushed over to him. She threw her arms around his neck and buried her face in his chest. After crying for a few minutes, she looked up at him. "I just talked to your doctor," she wailed. "He said you only have 30 days to live." I got a good chuckle over that story, and I bet you did too. I imagine that this man's home life was probably less than perfect with all of his stress. You see, stress ushers in all kinds of unwanted pressures and problems into our partnerships and parenting. Stress makes us distracted, it makes us self-obsessed, and it makes us numb. It can creep in silently, almost unrecognizable at first. Then you start feeling the physical symptoms, the headaches, the neck aches, the stomach problems, the chronic colds. And then the mental problems come. You face anxiety, depression, and overwhelm. And finally, the emotional problems take their toll. Withdrawal from your spouse, a short temper with your kids, and zero empathy for anybody but yourself. Let's read Romans 8, 38 through 39. "For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." Many of you were raised by stressed out parents. And many of us are raising children in a very, very stressed out world. Can I encourage you with something today? No matter what kind of mother or father you were raised by, God is your perfect heavenly Father. He doesn't get stress. He never loses empathy for you. He never grows tired of you. And He always has time for you. Guess what else, moms and dads? God covers you so much that He can provide for your kids where you can't. Do you know all those feelings that you have at the end of the day where you feel like you got a capital F failure as a parent? Even then, God is extending grace over you and meeting your children's needs right where you can't. So friends, remember this. God is your perfect heavenly Father. Let's let go of the stress and give thanks for that good news today. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning.